My topic is the statue of Zeus. Started out in Greece in 776 BC. The Olympics began in Peloponnesus in Greece. They were held at a shrine in Zeus. The shrine of Zeus was okay for a couple of years, but as the Olympics grew in importance, they felt like they needed a larger temple. So the temple of Zeus was built from between 466 BC to 456. The designer of the temple was Leban Ellis. Around 432 BC, Phidias began crafting the statue of Zeus. Phidias was an Athenian sculptor, and around 432 BC, he finished it. The statue of Zeus was a testament to hard work, creativity, and skill of humans earlier. And the statue of Zeus was a great piece of work and was amazing to architectural history. I've been studying ancient architecture, and I've been studying Zeus in Greek mythology for a while. And first I'm going to go and discuss the Greek god, then the temple, and then finally the statue of Zeus. This is Zeus. He's the god of sky and weather, also the guardian of political peace and order. He was the sixth son of Cronus and Rhea, and he ended up marrying Hera. Hera is the goddess of marriage and protector of married women. Zeus publications state that Zeus as a god was more powerful than every god combined, but he wasn't able to do everything, and he didn't know everything. He had no control over destiny. He was subject to anger, love, grief, pleasure, and pain. Being the god of sky, he was responsible for rain, thunderstorms, droughts, and he had many other titles such as rain god, lord of sky, Zeus thunder, and cloud gatherer. He held a scepter with an eagle on top in his left hand, and in his right he held a Nike. Nike was the winged goddess of victory, and he, being the guardian of political peace and order, he saw that each deity performed their duty, and he punished them for all their misdeeds. He didn't get involved in any scheming or arguments between the gods. He settled any dispute, pretty much. Next, I'm going to go on to discuss the Temple of Zeus, which was dedicated to him. The Temple of Zeus is an ancient Greek temple in Olympia, Greece. Construction on it started between 470 and 460 BC. The temple actually is supported by 13 columns on the left and 6 on the ends. The designer was Leban Ellis. It was completed in 456 BC. It was created because of the growing importance of the Olympics, and they felt like they needed something bigger to show and give it honor, give the Olympics honor. It was similar to other Grecian temples, and it was raised on a rectangular platform, and it resembled closely to the Parthenon in Athens. The pediments, which are these right here, the pediments had sculptures on the tops, and just under each, just under each pediment right here, showed the 12 labors of Heracles. Heracles is the son of Zeus, and he's also a Greek hero. Now going on to the statue of Zeus. The statue of Zeus was created because the temple was too simple in the Greeks' eyes, and they wanted to show more to Zeus. The statue of Zeus depicted the size and power of the god, and according to SolveSchools.com, the god was depicted in the statue sitting in a wooden throne, bare-chested. The throne's armrests were two carved sphinxes. Sphinxes are mythical creatures that have the head and chest of women, but the body of a lion and wings of a bird. Research by Lee Christek of ummuseum.org said that the height of the statue was 40 feet tall, and it was 22 feet wide. And it was decorated in gold and ivory. Now Phidias, the Athenian sculptor who built the statue, he was he completed around mid-5th century BC. He called up to Zeus after creating the statue for approval of his work, and shortly after, the temple was struck by lightning, according to legend. According to establishedhistory.com, the statue was later moved to Constantinople in 462 AD and was destroyed in the fire, so there's no remaining. Now, to end it, today I discussed the Greek god, then I want to discuss the temple, and finally, the statue of Zeus. The statue of Zeus, one of the seven wonders of the ancient world, is an amazing work of art, and it should never be forgotten, regardless whether there's not much to find of it anymore.